So what are just some basic stroke symptoms? Weakness, numbness, especially on one side of the body, especially. You know, as you know, the brain, one side, you know, of the brain, say the left side goes to the right side of the body. So anytime it's just on one side, that's even more the chance it's going to be stroke than something else. Difficulty speaking or understanding speech. This is the hard one. Someone's old, has dementia potentially, or they're not, you know, they don't communicate that well in general. Really hard sometimes to tell the difference between a speech problem and some of those other things, or infection. Are they just encephalopathic? So we always want to make sure we've ruled out stroke. Also, we're very aggressive with aphasia, loss of speech, because it's a very devastating injury and causes a lot of disability. So that's one we want to check very carefully for. Vision loss in one or both eyes, okay? A severe headache that's unusual for that patient. You know, some people will call this a thunderclap headache, worst headache of their life. They've never had a headache like this. That often can be a sign of a hemorrhagic stroke. Now, dizziness, and let me just say, the word dizziness, you know, depending on where you're at, what people mean by that varies regionally. There are three things people can mean when they say dizzy, and I've tried to just learn to kind of ask specifically about these. So dizziness can mean feeling, for some people, means they feel lightheaded, as if they're going to faint. Okay, that's one thing people can mean. That's usually not a stroke. But there are two other things that could be a stroke. When people say dizziness, the other things they could mean are they could mean vertigo. Some people, when they say they're dizzy, they mean vertigo, the sensation that the room is spinning, like they've just gotten off of a carnival ride, something like that. That, if it has another symptom associated with it or is acute in onset and doesn't go away, that could be the sign of a very dangerous stroke. Okay. Then the other could be, when they say they're dizzy, they may also mean they can't get their balance. And that could also be the sign of a stroke. They could have what we call proprioceptive loss. You know, they could have a stroke that caused sensory deficits and now they can't get their balance, or a cerebellar stroke. So dizziness and vertigo could be signs of very dangerous, subtle stroke. So if they mean those two things by dizziness, then that certainly could be. And especially if they say, I'm kind of numb, I'm really dizzy, I have a facial droop, and I'm really dizzy, and they mean vertigo, well, that's something that could be a very bad stroke. So those are the symptoms, all right? But so obviously location in the brain determines what symptoms you have. And, you know, there's, you know, you've got a little, you know, picture up here, a little graphic. So the frontal lobe, really hard to tell that someone's had a stroke. They can have a very big stroke in the frontal lobe and we don't notice a whole lot. It's pretty subtle, especially acutely. But now if someone has trouble understanding language, then that's what we call from Wernicke's area. And that's in the parietal lobe there. And that's going to be someone who has, you know, they're able to, they can't follow commands, right? They may be able to verbalize, to say some nonsense, but they cannot follow commands. And then we have Wernicke's area, which is another area where people just, they can't understand language there. And so then Broca's area is where you express language. So they may be able to understand you, but they don't say anything. Maybe they just seem quiet. Maybe you think they're just stressed out, you know, maybe you think they're really anxious and they're not saying anything. That can certainly be a stroke. And in terms of isolated aphasias, the way the blood vessels break down is the middle cerebral artery comes in from the carotid and then it divides in two, and part of it goes superior and part of it goes inferior. And so the superior part, usually if you get a stroke there, usually will affect the arm too. But you can certainly get a stroke where people can understand you but can't say a whole lot, and it'd be just Broca's area, and it'd just be aphasia. And it could even be close enough there to be amenable to a thrombectomy. So that's the one, you know, we worry about sometimes, and even though, you know, they're not weak, if they have trouble with language, especially expressing language, they might still have a really big debilitating stroke. And so the occipital lobe, like we said, is vision, and then the temporal lobe, it's harder to see a whole lot more from that. So obviously, you know, the stroke will, as a rule, without getting into some of the more complicated brainstem syndromes, is going to be on the opposite side. So then we think about whether there are cortical signs, and that's important for us. And then we think about whether there's a distribution that makes sense with where the blood vessels are. And this can help us tease out between things like conversion disorder or a stroke, or maybe it's a spinal cord issue. So that helps us some. So obviously the left side of the brain controls the right side of the body. The right side controls the left side. Now, these cross somewhere in the brainstem. You know, that we have what we call the decussation of the pyramids. And so it goes opposite. And most of you know that. And this is just a picture to show you where these cross over. And so, you know, if it's spinal cord, it's going to be same side. If it's brain, it's going to be opposite side.